Hey guys, welcome to Krista NC Baril. Today we're going to be making no-bake pumpkin pie. If you're into vegan recipes and lifestyle, then stick around for more. Also, stick around to the end and I'll show you what to do if you want to pizzazz it up a little more. So to start, we're going to make our crust, and you're just going to want to start by pulsing together some pecans and soaked dates. If your dates aren't soaked, it's okay. It's not going to kill your recipe. And then you're going to want to add some coconut water if you need to, if it doesn't create a ball. And once it's in a nice, like, sticky consistency, transfer that over to a pan and create your crust and just spread it all out. And then we're gonna make our pie filling by starting with some ginger, apples. If you don't have apples, it'll be better if you have persimmons, but I used apples as a substitute. And then your pumpkin, you wanna use a sweet pumpkin pie pumpkin. They're smaller and they're more sweet. And then save those seeds because we're gonna use those to make some pumpkin seeds. And you're gonna wanna take off the skins and dice up your pumpkin. Then you're going to want to transfer your pumpkin, ginger, everything, and apples that we sliced up and put them in a pan so they could soften. Add your vanilla bean, mix it up to give it some more flavor, and again, let it soften until it's nice and soft and mushy. Transfer that to a blender and blend it all up with some cashews and dates. And if you don't have a blender or you have a small one, you can use a food processor, which is actually what I ended up doing here. You're also going to want to add your pumpkin spice. I forgot to do that in the beginning, so you add it before the end, and then when it's all smooth, transfer over to your baking pan. And if you want to add a little more pizzazz, add some young coconut to the bottom layer, and then put your pumpkin pie on top and smooth it all out. Once you're done smoothing it all out, drop it on your counter a couple times to take out all the air bubbles, and then decorate it. I decorated mine with leftover coconut and pecans and set it in your fridge or freezer to set. If you put it in the freezer, you just need an hour of fridge. You probably want to do it overnight. Once your pie is done setting, you're going to want to take a knife and release it from the sides of the pan, and then your pie is ready to serve and eat. If you guys try this out, let me know. I'd love to see your photos. Tag me on Instagram and wherever on at Krista NC Baril. And I hope you stick around for more for next week when we make stuff with the pumpkin seeds. And if you like this video, please be sure to give it a nice thumbs up and subscribe if this is the content you're into. And again, I hope you guys stick around for more, and I'll see you next week. Bye.